Hello, how are you?
Thank you, fine. To meet you, and I'm too happy to see you here.
Yes, thank you very much. First of all, I wish all of you a healthy, happiness, and nice wishes, all of you.
Thank you.
And also, I would like to thank organizing committee, and especially to you, to Arman. And I appreciate to our university, University of Health Science, Istanbul, Turkey, and myself. In the beginning of this conference, I listened very nice lectures, especially in herbal therapy. And also my speech is a two parts. First part is a what we did in last 10 years in Turkey as a complementary and traditional and complementary medicine, TCM. And the second part, I will talk about our clinical outcomes in COVID-19. Now we are faced with on the rarely seen pandemics in human history nowadays in the new world order, where speed and soulless relations are the main theme, and where fast food, fast movement, fast and soulless social relation, media sharing, etc., following rapidly. COVID-19 is a warning to humanity to stop and evaluate life starting by one's own self. It's like a wake-up call for us and provide us insight and self-realization. In such environment, TCM approach like personalized treatments, holistic approaches, integration are on agenda. While millennial medicine application have been shown as evidence for treatment thought as use of algorithms, thousands of years of experience from TCM applications have not been taken into account enough. This is my disappointing. We don't use the extremely this holistic approach, integrative approach. We use very rarely TCM applications. Physicians who are interested in traditional and complementary medicine have to urge to act individually, not being able to come together and form their own algorithms. The fact that Big Pharma is against the cheap medicine due to their profit motive, TCM philosophy is living healthy lifestyle and applying prevent medicine, supported immune system, integrative treatment approach provide short duration of hospital stay and intensive care, in my opinion. TCM applications and millennial medicine can work together in integratively manner which support rather than opposes each other. This is my main idea. What we did in Turkey, Minister of Health, Traditional and Complementary Medicine Department, our aim is to make arrangements regarding the institution, individuals, and process working in the field of the evidence-based traditional and complementary medicine practice to contribute to human healthy by integrating with modern medicine and complementary medicine application. In Turkey, 15 subgroups of traditional complementary medicine we accreditate, for example, traditional as an acupuncture or iridotherapy, and a complementary as an ozone therapy and the other facilities. And also, we will integrate Ayurveda in the list in the near future. And also, 2014, there is a very strong regulation in Turkey, and then World Health Organization also to recommend the other country this regulation. According to this legislation, practitioners should be medical doctors, dentists at their fields, and pharmacists to prepare remedy at homeopathy. In Turkey, nearly almost 5,000 practitioners are certificated by several universities. And normally, I am a professor in urology, and also I am the head doctor of the our university, the University of Health Science in Istanbul, Turkey, head of the traditional complementary medicine department, and we have a 32 students at totally for medical science, master science, and PhD programs, doctorates and PhD programs. These students are working at highly academic fashion on TCM subjects such as MOXA and acupuncture, at pregnancy, breech presentation, or migraine, to neurology and hypnosis in erectile dysfunction in urology daily practice. And during this training, each student participates in clinical studies, writing medical articles, presenting medical posters, and translating books. These activities are geared towards different traditional medicine around the world. Within the COVID-19 pandemic, we are oriented towards clinical trials reinforcement to treatment of COVID-19. And then especially in this process, we are 3 clinical studies in our hospitals: rectal ozone application, a herbal liquid and inhale mixture, and toothpaste for oral cavity health to COVID-19 outpatients and intensive care units. For example, the other the last news from Turkey today, yesterday, 29th May, and we nearly 2 million tests in this COVID fiolation program. And also we have a nearly 160,000 cases. We checked the test, and then 4,000, nearly 500 the death of this from COVID. And then in intensive care units, nearly 1,000 intensive care units patients, the sum of them is tube, and the other one is tubeless. And then healing number of the patients is nearly 125,000 people in Turkey. This is the one summary of from Turkey. When I come back to our clinical, what we did clinically, first we separated 3 group the patients. One of the very they are going outpatient group. The other is moderate group, is in internal intern in the hospital. The severe group in the intensive care units. First of all, our experience in diagnosis of COVID-19, the thorax CT was performed in the patient with the pre-diagnosis of COVID-19 to make an early diagnosis for atypical pneumonia. As we know that we have many tests, quick tests, PCR tests, immunoglobulin tests, but all of them they have some positive or negative defects for this test. So we use usually thorax CT and laboratory tests and electrocardiogram and further study immunoglobulin M and immunoglobulin G. For outpatients COVID without pneumonia, when we after diagnosis, we start the hydroxychloroquine 200 milligram BAD 5 days, and azithromycin is included 5 milligram dose. And the isolation, and then we are sending this patient to home, isolation at home, was recommended for suspicion patient for 14 days. And family physicians is very clearly, very extremely followed up them by phone call regarding any deterioration. If there was a suspicion condition in healthy workers, PCR tests were re-performed after 14 days in health workers. At the moderate patient, for patient mild disease with pneumonia, we start loading dose 400 milligram hydroxychloroquine, and then 2 from China, and then azithromycin. We are using this severe pneumonia. When we look at the world, what's our success of our treatment? When we compare the world, for example, in Europe country, we start the treatment very early. We don't wait time, and then very early we started, and then protective approach is the three main sentences: face mask using, social isolation, 2 meters, and hand hygiene is very important. And also face mask using and social isolation, citizens over 65 and younger than 20 years of age have been isolated at their homes, and educational model immediately converted from the formal to web-based integrative model. All citizens traveled from abroad were placed in the dormitories and isolated for 14 days, and then etc. And also hand hygiene. And in our center, in my hospital, I am also the head doctor of the big hospital. And then in our center, approximately 22,000 patients were applied within this period. And then nasopharyngeal sample from PCR was obtained about nearly 4,300 tests were positive. And then initially, considering seasonal agent, plaquenil and azithro and Tamiflu, oseltamivir, combination therapy was given to cover whole microbiologic spectrum. For patients with a suspicion of COVID-19 and do not require the for admissions, this is hydroxychloroquine and oseltamivir for 5 days at home. And all patients and any evidence of COVID-19 were admitted to hospital and received combination therapy. And also, all the patients with lung involvement, regardless of the severity, were admitted to the hospital and drug therapy was administered. Within the following period, favipiravir was added to treatment for patients with moderate to severe lung involvement. And the last one, due to the drug interaction, oral antidiabetic drugs were converted to insulin. The patient is using hydroxychloroquine because of the metabolic acidosis and severe hypoglycemia. Thank you for your attention. This is my speech. Also, thank you for Tehran University, for Dr. Arman. My take-home messages is, as you know, I mentioned about me, I am the one professor in urology. But last 10 years, I am interested in the traditional and complementary medicine. My home take-home messages is we must use integratively to Western medicine and traditional and complementary medicine. Also, I am very disappointed in this period in Turkey. We use very rarely the traditional and complementary methodology in these patients. Thank you very much again for your attention.
Thank you, Ahmed. Thank you, Ahmed.
You're welcome.
Thank you for your very nice presentation. Sağ ol. Güle güle.
Thank you.
Okay, let's start the next presentation with Arash, Dr. Arash Shirvani. Arash, do you hear me? Arash? Dr. Shirvani, do you hear me? Okay, it seems that Arash is not connected yet. I ask the next speaker, Dr. Mohammad Hussein Ayati, to start the presentation, and then after that we will connect to Dr. Arash. Okay, Dr. Ayati, please come and. Thank you.